points we see the numericals on the basis of concave mirror. Now we see the numericals. Suppose the object is placed at 10 cm in front of concave mirror. So object distance should be denoted by u. So 10 cm should be there. And the radius of curvature of the concave mirror is also given. Radius of curvature, that is r. R is given, that is 30 cm. Now find the image distance, that is v. Image distance, that is v. You have to find magnification, find and find the nature. Now from given data, we have to use the mirror formula. Concave mirror or convex mirror, same formula is there, only sign changes is there. In concave mirror or convex mirror, the u is taken on the left side, so it is denoted by negative sign. And radius of curvature for concave mirror is negative because it is on the left side. So focal length is the half of radius of curvature, that is r by 2. So what should be the focal length? 30 by 2, that is 15 cm. But focal length for the concave mirror is on the left side, so it is a minus 15 cm. So we have to find the image distance v. Put in the mirror formula, 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. F is find, that is 15 cm minus 15. V we have to find, plus 1 by u. U is minus 10. So 1 by minus 15 equal to plus into minus minus 1 by 10. Take the 1 by 10 on this side, so you will get the 1 by v. So 1 by v is equal to 1 by minus 15 minus, that will be shifted to 1 by plus 1 by 10. So 1 by v is equal to, what should be the cross multiplication? 1 into 10, that is 10, plus into minus minus 15 upon minus 15 into 10, that is minus 150. So you will get the value minus 5 by minus 150. 1 by v, minus minus cancel. But what should be v? V is equal to, taking reciprocal of this, 150 by 5. So it should be 30 cm. So v is plus 30 cm you are getting. So it means that if the v is plus, then image will be formed on the right side because it is a plus. Now we have to find the magnification and then nature. First we find the magnification of the mirror. What is the formula for magnification of mirror? The magnification is written in the formula as m is equal to minus v upon u. Because in mirror formula there is plus, so in magnification there is opposite, that is minus. So what is the value of v? That is 30. So minus is there, 30 minus 30 upon. What is the value of u? U is minus 10. So minus minus 10, so you get magnification plus 3. If the magnification is plus and greater than 1, if value is greater than 1, then image is magnified image. Means magnified, you can say larger image. And if the value is positive, then that is a virtual and erect image. Virtual and erect image. So in this way, if the value is greater than 1, then it is a magnified or larger image than the object. It is positive 3, that's why it's a virtual and erect. Okay, so for negative we write the real and inverted, for positive we write the virtual and erect. In this way we find the value of image distance and magnification, and nature is magnified and virtual and erect. This is the nature in this way. So in this way we can find the value of f, m and their nature. Now if you take the convex mirror, what should be changes? If you take the convex mirror in place of concave mirror, what should be changes there? The value should be taking same. If you take the u is equal to 10, that should be minus. F will be 15, but here plus 15 you have to take. In concave mirror focal length is positive because on the right side focal length is formed. And you have to find the v and m here. So for the same value, but convex mirror, mirror formula is same, 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u, but here f is positive and in concave mirror f was negative. So 1 by f means 1 by 15 because focal length is positive, 1 by v and plus into minus minus 1 by 10. So if you take the 1 by 10 on this side, so it will be plus 1 by 15 plus 1 by 10 equal to 1 by v. So cross multiplication, 10 plus 15 by 15 is 150. So we can find 25 divided by 150 equal to 1 by v. So how can you find? V is equal to, taking reciprocal, 150 by 25. So what should be there? 6. So 6 centimeter. So what should be the value of V? 6 centimeter. Is there changing the value of the concave and convex mirror? Yes. There was the value of V will be 30. Here 6. So there will be changes in the V. Magnification is also changes. So how can your magnification change? M equal to minus V upon U. Minus 6 upon, what is the value of U? Minus 10. So you will get 0.6. This is less than 1. This is less than 1, that is smaller image. So smaller image is formed, smaller you can say diminished image is formed. Diminished means smaller image is formed. And this value is positive, that's why it's a virtual and erect. So virtual and erect image is formed. Like this you can find for the convex mirror also. So in this way we can find for concave and convex mirror the numerical for magnification and focal image formation. We seen here the convex mirror, concave mirror, but after that there is some spherical lenses. That lenses are of two types. One is convex lens and second is concave lens. What is convex lens? If the lens is outward bulging on both the side, that is a double convex lens, or you can say convex lens. And if the both sides inward curvature, then it is a concave lens. Outward curvature, that is convex lens, and inward curvature, that is concave lens. This is a concave, this is a convex. So for the lens, concave lens or convex lens, there is a center point, that is a optic center. Through that optic center some axis is passes, that is called as the principal axis. Principal axis is there. Through that optic center, the axis is passed, that is called principal axis. And the incident ray, incident on the lens, that is parallel to the principal axis, is refracted and bent toward the principal axis and passes through point, that is a focus. So parallel rays incident on the lens, convex lens, will be converges at some point on the principal axis, that is called as focus, and distance of the focus from the optic center is called as focal length. Distance of the focus from the optic center is called as focal length. Double the focal length, there will be some distance, that is a center of curvature. On both the side you can take F and C. Here if you take F1 C1, so you take F2 C2. So focal length and focus is on both the side you can take, and center of curvature is can be taken on both the side, because if you extend this circle it will form on this side, if you extend this circle this will form on this side. So from two circle the convex lens is prepared like this. Two sphere will be there form, that's why there will be the focus and focal length at the center of curvature is on both the side. So we consider the focal length and the center of curvature on both the side of the lenses, because the sphere of the imaginary sphere of the lens is on both the side. Here also there will be the imaginary sphere on this side also, and here there is also imaginary sphere on this side also. Center of the sphere is joined by some axis, principal axis, and here there is some gap between the two sphere, and that center is the optic center. Here center of curvature C1, here center of curvature C2. here radius of curvature r1, here radius of curvature r2. So from the optic center, the distance of one side from center of curvature is radius of curvature, and that is on the both side of the sphere, both side in the sphere. So concave lens is formed by joining the two sphere at a small distance, and convex lens is formed by converging or by mixing two sphere inside each other, so it will form convex lens. So in this way we study about the convex lens and concave lens. In next period we see how the images form in the convex lens and concave lens. Okay, so we stop here. So do you understood this point? So everybody can understand this. So thank you for the today's topic.